All right, so now we've arrived at the first major pain point in moving from Java to C, which is that string manipulation is much more difficult in C because of the way that you're accessing memory at a lower level and because C doesn't really have built-in primitives for manipulating strings. So for instance, in Java, you could concatenate two strings simply using the plus operator. So in Java, this line would take str1 and concatenate str2 onto it and give you a new string that consisted of these two strings concatenated. So it's worth taking a second to think about, well, what would this code do in C? So if we had str1, which is a pointer to a null terminated string in memory, and then we have str2, which is a pointer to another null terminated string in memory, what does this line of code do? So maybe it's worth pausing the video for a second and thinking about what this does. So it doesn't do what you probably think it does. So in Java, this would create a new string called dest for destination, and it would copy str1 and str2 into that new location. But that's not what's happening here, because str1 is just a pointer to the first string, and str2 is a pointer to the second string. Now, I've drawn them consecutively here, so str2 is right after str1 in memory. That's not necessarily the case, right? They could be in entirely different places in memory. And so str1 is going to be some address in memory, str2 is going to be another address in memory, and when we add those two addresses together, that's just pointer arithmetic. We're just taking the first address and we're adding the second address, and we're taking that addition, so that's going to end up being some random place in memory that just happens to be the addition of the address of this string plus the address of this string, and that's what destination is going to be. It's just going to be a pointer to some random place in memory. So obviously that's no good. That's not what we really intended here, and that's not what we want. And so unfortunately what we're going to have to do is a little bit more work than we have to do in Java. We have to manually allocate space for the destination, and we need to copy all the characters from the concatenated strings into the new location. So we need to be able to copy strings, and so this is going to involve copying all the characters from one string to another, and obviously this is something that people have needed to do before, and so there are existing solutions for it. Unfortunately, this is also a common source of both bugs and security vulnerabilities. So the old solution for copying strings was this function called strcopy, and this was part of the C standard, it still is. It's deprecated now. Or at least discouraged now. So it takes a destination pointer and a source pointer and basically just copies from source into destination until it reaches the null terminator. But there's a problem with this, and in order to understand that, think about what happens if source is not null terminated. So think for a second about what would happen if source did not actually have a null character at the end. Well, if that happens, then you're just going to keep reading past the end of the string, and you're just going to read data from random places in your address space into destination. And this is what you would call an out-of-bounds error in Java. Unfortunately, unless you happen to hit a region of memory that you're not allowed to access, C is just going to let you do this, and you're just going to be you're just going to keep copying data from places in memory after source into places of in memory after destination. So for this reason, using strcopy is now considered unsafe. So for this reason, you are not permitted to use this function in CS261. And so in order to get around this and make this safe again, we need to specify a maximum length that is safe to copy. So that's usually the length of the allocated destination. There is an older alternative here called strincopy that does this. It does require maximum length. Unfortunately, this has a slightly different problem, which is that it doesn't guarantee the result is null terminated. There is also a newer alternative called strcopy-s, which is considered safer and is null terminated. However, it's not in the C99 standard, which is what we're using in this course. So all that to say, the better alternative that we're going to use in this course for string copying is snprintf. This function is safe, it is C99 standard, and it is far more powerful than any of the other two, and you can actually use this for generic string copying and string formatting. So printf, which is what we've been using to print to the screen, and snprintf, which we use to print to strings, are very conceptually similar. So the former just prints to standard out, the latter prints, quote unquote, to a string, which is a region in memory, again, just an array of characters. And so the latter can also copy strings, and it can take non-string data like integers or floating point numbers, and it can convert them to strings. So basically, printf is snprintf without a buffer and a buffer size. Otherwise, you invoke them all similarly. So here's how you would copy a string from source string to dest string. So you need to know the size of destination string, and you pass that in as the maximum size. And then your format specifier is just a string, so it's %s. So this is what you would use in order to copy source string into dest string. Just for your reference here, this is also how you could convert an integer to a string or a floating point number to a string.